will literally show you the career that you've been wanting to see.
Yes, it is time to experience the nooks and crannies of Korea as if with your own two feet on...
K-Patch!
With Jennifer Jin.
It is a Thursday. If you can, you must see the video stream today more than any other day because Jane comes in with some brilliant little videos that she's filmed. We do post them up onto the social media account so you can see them afterwards if it's not convenient for you now. But we do also have the live stream via the application, the website, and YouTube on Air Arirang Radio and VLive as well. How are you doing, Jen?
Wow, that's a lot of channels that you guys can reach out to.
Too many, yes, sometimes.
Audience, which is great.
You also reach out via your social media, YouTuber Jen, if you want to follow her.
Mm-hmm. Jen from Korea.
There you go. Subscribe away. Have you had a good week?
I've had a pretty good week, yeah. I mean, the weather is nice, and I'm so excited to share this content today.
Yay.
As we've been talking, which is we're going off this peninsula,
yes,
right?
We're going to
an island.
I don't know if we've ever been to Jeju-do Island or, in fact, anywhere off the peninsula.
You mean from this segment?
On K-Patch, yeah. Mm-hmm. Me, personally, I have left Korea before, yeah. Yes, of course. But on K-Patch, I think we've mostly, if not exclusively, stuck to the mainland, yeah.
So I would be the first.
Yes.
Wow.
It's like a new frontier. It's like we're going to space or something like that. And just FYI, before we get into things, but just like for your reference, in Korea, there are many different ways of translating things. So on Arirang Radio, we like to say Jeju-do Island. Some people otherwise leave out the door because do means island.
Yes.
So they're like, well, that means Jeju-do Island, island. Mm-hmm. But there are different standards at different organizations. So you could just call it Jeju, mm-hmm. Jeju-do, Jeju-do Island, or Jeju Island, whatever takes your fancy. But here on Arirang, our format is do and then island said afterwards, just so you know. We've got a hashtag, though, Jen, before we move on.
Today
it is 새벽, mm-hmm. or early hours. First, I wanted to ask you this.
Yeah.
In the dictionary, when mm-hmm. you type in 새벽, it says dawn or break of dawn. So that's what, when the sun comes up at 5 or 6 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm, in English, saying early hours, which means like the really late night and just before dawn.
Oh.
And so in Korean, can 새벽 mean both of those things? Because you say like 새벽 2시, 새벽 3시.
Yeah.
So it can mean both dawn and also like the middle of the night.
Yeah, that's true. I did not think of it that way. For me, 새벽 is just so something that I use so commonly.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. We use 새벽 before dawn as well.
And literally for dawn too. That could be confusing then. If I said, 새벽에 만나, let's meet at, when would that mean? Would it mean dawn or would it mean the late night?
So, you know, for Koreans, we usually put the time after 새벽. So let's meet at 새벽 5시 or 새벽 the time.
Okey-dokey.
We don't just say 새벽에 만나.
Because that's too vague, I guess, right? Yeah, you'd be... I guess in English, you wouldn't say, let's meet in the early hours, because that could mean any time between midnight and like 5 or 6 a.m. When was the last time you were awake at 새벽? Are you often awake in the early hours, Jen?
Oh, so I did try to get up early like a year ago.
Oh.
I remember reading this book saying you have your free time when you can truly be free and make a real change from 4 a.m.
Oh, wow. Okay? I think you talked about this on the show briefly at the time.
I mean, the title was 새벽 4시 something. And I got so much inspiration from that book. So I've been following that principle for like a week. And
I thought you were going to say a year, but just a week.
A week. And it was amazing experience, really, which I hope to continue. Which I'm trying.
What, if it was amazing, what happened after that week?
I mean, as a mother, you know, it's so hard to have your alone time. Just be yourself alone, fully focusing on yourself.
Oh, yeah.
And at some point, I realized that the only time I have is when I'm in the car alone on my way to Arirang.
That's your precious time.
Kidding.
Wow.
So yeah, I tried to preserve that time in the morning.
Well, I guess if you wake up at 4 a.m., your kid is probably still asleep. Mm-hmm. So maybe that could be the alone time
as well.
Right,
exactly.
Oh, so that could be quite precious. Because I think many parents, instead, what they do is the opposite. They will stay up late because they'll put their kid to sleep.
Right.
And then it might be like, I don't know, 10 p.m. or something
That's
like that.
That's my current routine.
Yeah. And
actually,
then my wife loves to then use that time to look on her phone and scroll the internet for like hours.
You know, Korean moms have this saying, yukte, this word. Have you heard about that?
Yukte, it's a combination, right?
Yeah, yung means child caring, yuga, it's from yuga. And tuegun is the word when you finish your work from your company, your workplace.
Yeah, to clock off in English, maybe.
Yeah, so it's a combination of those two words. It's like finally having that free time
so you're
after work.
Clocking off from childcare. And I've heard of terms like yukte mekju. So you'll have a beer once you've finished child rearing and stuff like this. And many mums in Korea especially love to do that, I feel. So on to today's topic. We're really excited to go down to Jeju-do Island.
Yay!
What are we going to see in your first video? Because Jeju-do Island is pretty big.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, I'm glad that you mentioned that. Just so you know, this is a huge island. So what I'm going to show you would be like a little percentage of the full content that you can enjoy from this island. And I have divided into two parts as always. In the first video, you're about to see some beautiful nature and some tourist spots.
Oh.
And in part two, I'm going to show you some local foods.
Oh, nice. So that's how it's separated. So let's start with the local attractions and the beautiful nature in video one.
So I wanted to start off with this beautiful blue ocean.
Where are you?
And the trees from the hotel that
stayed.
It's called Kensington Resort, just so you know.
And lots of windmills there for the power.
Yeah, and I wanted to show you this seaside driveway near this Soesokkak that you're about to see. It's in the southern part of Jeju-do Island.
Driving on the sea almost.
Mm-hmm. And this is a Soesokkak. You might wonder what this is.
Uh-huh.
Well, this is very well-known tourist spots. That this is like a stream from a village that leads to the sea.
Okay. So, and people like play around in here?
Right.
Wow.
Nearby this festival.
Why is there nobody there?
People were on other side at that moment. And this is the Songsan Ilsulbong, which is another really famous
volcanic crater cone thing.
So Jeju-do is made of volcanic activities, and there are a lot of Oreum that you're seeing right now. Oreum means a little, kind of like a hill made from the volcanic movement. And this is another of that, Sambangsan. It's a mountain.
Oh, that's beautiful. I've not seen that.
It's another really famous mountain, and nearby you can see the temple. Below you can see there, and right in front of this Sambangsan mountain you can see the beautiful Yongmori beach, which means dragon head beach.
It's meant to look like a dragon head.
Yeah.
The rock
does
formation.
It look like a dragon head?
Is that the dragon
head? That is the dragon head part.
I guess it could look like a dragon lying down.
So this is the beach that has been designated by UNESCO.
Oh, really?
In 2010.
It looks rather like muddy and dark.
Yeah.
But I guess that's the volcanic rock and stuff around there. I've also seen another area not far from the airport near Jeju City that has some dragon head rock formation, a much smaller one that, I don't know, from some angles kind of really did look like a dragon.
Yeah.
Like the one that you just showed us there. It's quite a big light cliff if you weren't watching the video. It's not very detailed like a dragon's head.
As you said, it might look much more similar from a specific angle. I could just film it from only that spot. But
I see.
There is this opening hour where you can actually take a walk along that cliff.
Oh, nice.
That you just saw there.
Wow.
Yeah, there's a path where you can really feel the rock and the cliff. And there are like haenyeodeul, which we call it, who are the females who catch the seafood and sell it at the same time.
Yeah, they
and
dive down
without any oxygen divers. Tanks or anything, right. right? They just hold their breath and go down there. The most amazing thing to me in that video that I'd not seen is that mountain that was in the middle, not Songsang Ilchibong, because that's very famous, right?
Yeah.
That's the kind of cone shape that you can walk up and look into. It's like a big bowl. But the one after that, the one...
Samdangsan?
Yeah, where's that?
Well, it's also near the Jungmun, which is the southern part of Jeju-do Island.
That's like a tourist resorty kind of area.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
It's a mountain, and it has the temple, and right in front of that mountain, you can see the Yongmori, the dragon head beach.
I see. Steve saying, I remember hiking up to Mount Sambang 6 years ago, and I saw the Buddhist temple at the top there. And for those of you who didn't watch the video, it's just like white rock going straight up.
Right.
Like, it's not a, like, gentle incline of a mountain. It doesn't look like a triangle. It's just kind of suddenly there.
Yeah, that's the beauty of the volcanic mountain, I suppose, right?
Wow,
the rock just heading straight right up to the sky.
Yeah, I don't know, because Hallasan is, like, the inactive volcano in the middle of the island, right? Mm-hmm. The big one there. The tallest mountain in South Korea, right? Nearly...
Yeah.
Or around 2,000 meters. And that is like gentle kind of incline to the top, right? It's not too steep. That Sambang Mountain, if you wanted to climb that, that looks pretty tricky
very
to
steep.
Go up. Yeah, I'm really impressed by that. Marilyn Wells saying, Jeju-do Island, woohoo, beautiful. So excited to learn of more places to visit when going on holiday. Marilyn, just for your information, Jen, is from New Zealand. So... Uh-huh. Being inspired by Jeju-do Island, I think that's to be proud of because New Zealand is famous for being wonderful, right? And Shelley saying, beautiful views, love the mountains. Jeju-do does seem like a lovely paradise. So did you stay on the south side? Is that where the resort was?
Yeah, I stayed for a day in the southern part.
Uh-huh.
And Songsan Ilchibong, if you can remember, that's on the west side.
East is the side, right?
East side.
Yeah,
Thank you for that.
You're right.
So that was my the stay for my second day.
Right? You did two different places?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Very adventurous. Because when I have my kids, I only like to stay in one place because they make such a mess. Mm. If you move to another place, you've got to clear up, put it in the other place. That's a parenting tip. Just stay in one place.
I know. But I travel for you guys, actually. I wanted to show as many spots as I can. And actually, next week, I'm going to show you the Udo, which is very close to the Songsan Ilchibong.
It's another island.
Side. Yeah.
Oh, famous for its peanuts, I think, right? Oh, I'm looking forward to that next week already. Right, we'll get to the food in Jeju.
Where you can see a row of Hukdeji restaurant, which means black pork.
Oh, just a whole row of those restaurants.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. But what I want to say, Aaron, is lots of other parts of the island are beautiful. And I would say, and it might be controversial, the best beaches aren't in Jungmun because they're a bit hard to get down to from some of the hotels. You have to walk down loads of steps. There's Wolchongdi is one of my favorite beaches. And there's cafes in front. So on the east and north coast, you'll get lots of different places. You don't have to stay in the south, right?
No, yeah, you're right. I mean, there's so many beaches, and since you are also looking for non-beach activities, I also would recommend you to visit a lot of indoor fun facilities. Like, there's so many like museums, which isn't like the museum you're thinking, something that you can experience. Like, there's so many theme related parks, like Snoopy Garden and Flower Garden.
There's the Teddy Bear Museum down in Jungmun as well, which is pretty
famous.
There
are pretty famous, great relaxing temples.
Oh,
if you want to get that culture, history, relaxing vibe, temple is something that I will recommend as well.
Yeah, and just one that I've recommended on the show a few times because I absolutely loved it. They built it maybe 3 years ago. It's go-karting, but with a difference. There's no engine. You just go downhill. And so you're just steering, but it's a really high-tech go-kart because what it does, it goes to the bottom of the hill, which is really fun. And then it self-drives back up the top and you just sit in it and it drives by itself. It's like a remote control car or something. That's in, I believe it was central-ish in Jeju. You got some messages to read.
Yeah, from Stacy. Jeju Island is a beautiful part of my bucket list and it is a perfect place to bring your families.
Would you say so? You went with your son and your parents, did you?
Absolutely. I mean, this trip has been a bit challenging for me personally because I had to satisfy my parents and my kids. So I had to set aside what I would like to do the most. But definitely there's so many, again, facilities where kids like it, parents like it.
You're right.
There are so many kids' cafes and kids' facilities.
There is something for everyone. But as Jen honestly said, sometimes you might get pulled in one direction and another. But yeah, there is definitely something for everybody on the island.
Yeah.
Jenga saying hello to everyone. I'm sending some love at work, so I won't be in the chat much. That's okay to just listen. And Siska said, I love the Jungmun area too. So many places, museums, botanical gardens, the waterfall as well. Yeah, there's a reason why there's hotels in that area, because there's lots to see and do.
Yeah, and it's very convenient for one thing. Mm. But if you would want more wild, localish spots, then maybe Jungmun, you might feel it kind of a bit too, how should I say,
touristy,
artificial,
right.
Or yeah,
commercial.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and a lot of youngsters, including our former guest Chihi, who whenever she went to Jeju, she'd just choose like a cool little maybe pension or homestay experience. And those can be anywhere on the island, and you can meet other young people as well.
Yes.
Which is kind of nice, yeah.
Right.
You got
and
another
from
message?
Benny, for everyone wants to know more the island, listen to Wonders of Jeju at 10 p.m. KST, Korea time.
Yes.
Jeju-do Island is so lovely, and the mountain is lovely as well. I want to explore for the Hallasan Mountain.
Yeah, there's lots of courses on there, like for real hardcore hikers or for gentle walkers.
Have you ever climbed up the Hallasan Mountain?
No, I'm embarrassed.
It's been my bucket list.
I should, right? And you should.
Why are you embarrassed?
Because I've been there so many times and not gone up Hallasan Mountain. To be honest, I don't like hiking that much.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not my favorite thing. I'd rather sit on the beach.
And you're maybe more of a beach person.
Eat something.
Yeah, relax and just...
That sounds much
That's
nicer.
That's also nice.
Was it warm enough, by the way, when you went to go in the beach and the sand and the sea?
It was, actually, yeah. I mean, kids were having some good time. I did not go into the water when I was in the... I did when I was in Udo.
Okay.
So maybe the temperature was a bit more warm.
Nice, yeah, because I reckon in Jeju from about May, if you get a nice day, you can dip your feet in the sea. It's not too cold or anything. We are going to get to your second video then, Jen.
Yes.
And this is all about the food.
Oh, yes. I'm a foodie and I'm so excited about this content. Here
Let's
we go.
Check it out.
You know, there's so many Jeju Island food, so I'm sad that I can only cover a few of them. This is the Seongge Miyeokguk. I mean, if you love seafood, you should definitely come to Jeju-do Island.
Wow,
so
sea urchin
fishes.
Seaweed.
This is the Okdom, one of the local Jeju-do fish that is very famous. And this is the cutlass fish.
Oh,
Kalchi in Korean.
Cooked in a long, like,
pan. It's long because the whole... Kalchi is cooked, the whole one.
In one piece?
Full one
wow.
piece kalchi. And the staff there kindly, he was
Is
pouring,
that all
he
for
was
you?
Cutting, and for my family, yeah.
Oh, wow.
All for
So it's a personal,
family.
Like, long pot slash pan.
Yeah, and this is the black pork, steamed black pork.
It's called black pork because the pig's hairs are black,
yes.
Not the pork itself,
no.
Right?
And there were so many desserts that were really interesting. This is the hallabongbang. I don't know why they call it hallabong, but the, how should I say, the powder, that part, is from hallabong, the orange.
Okay.
So
and then inside is just bread.
Yeah, the cream, but
is it
had
nice?
This fruity
wow.
flavor. A little bit. I liked it.
The cafe itself is on the sea, it
that
looks like.
That was very near the place I stayed in Jungmun again.
Wow.
So that is where you see the beach seaside.
Oh, amazing. Mm-hmm. You're right. There are so many great foods. So let's just run through that for our listeners again. The first one was the Seongge Miyeokguk.
Mm-hmm.
Miyeokguk is that seaweed soup that we have, especially after we give birth. I say we. I didn't give birth, but for women, for many months after you have a baby.
Yeah, Miyeokguk, we eat it on birthdays, on those very special events. And usually we put in the, I mean, depending on your preference, you can put the usually beef.
Yes, as the base, right?
Or seafood as the base. But urchin, we've just seen, that is songge.
Wow, that's not common.
Very famous, not so common.
Was it good?
It was actually really nice.
Because you often, and I like it raw, like as a kind of sushi or chobap dish or in a bibimbap. Mm. I've never had it cooked. It still tastes okay.
It did, yeah. I mean, the base of the soup, it blended so well with the seaweed.
Nice. Oh,
it's hard to explain.
It
had this sea flavor.
Like you were eating boiled sea.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Boiled sea.
Yeah, and if you're thinking sea urchin and you're like, what? Because you're not familiar with it. It's the roe, I believe, right? It's not the spiky sea urchin itself. It's what's inside.
Yes.
And that's very prized here and in Japan as well.
Yeah.
And then after that, the okdom.
Okdom.
I wonder what that is called in English.
Tilefish?
I've never heard of that in English.
English?
Yeah.
Or blue. Okay, it's hard to. Blanquillo.
Wow.
I don't think that's English, but.
I'm seeing sea bream is also another one. There's many different names for many fish here in Korea in English, but that's one that's really associated with Jeju, right?
Yes. It's a very local fish dish.
I'm not the biggest
local
fan,
speciality
to be
of
honest. Like, I've had it a few times, and I don't know. It does taste distinct.
Yeah.
Like, it's not just any fish. Like, you don't know what you're eating. Mm. You know it's okdom. So for me, it was a bit... It wasn't grilled so much. So it's a little bit slimy, a little bit kind of fishy. And I think they salted it as well.
Yeah.
So it wasn't my cup of tea,
yeah,
to be honest.
You know, when I first had it for the first time, I had the similar impression that you've got. It was a bit too salty. And to me, it was less juicy compared to the godungo that we're used
mackerel,
to eat.
Which I love.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But the more I chew it, they have this deep flavor.
Oh.
Very deep sea.
Deep. Yeah. Well, you're
so
chewing
I
the
would
sea.
I personally recommend you guys to try it if you ever go to the island, because it's something that you rarely taste it in this peninsula.
Yeah. If you search it out, you'll find it, but it is associated with Jeju. And then the kalchi, which is what in English?
Cutless fish.
I have said that on the show before, and our English speakers still had no idea. But it's just, I think it might be called a cutlass fish, because a cutlass, I think, is a long sword, or if I'm not mistaken. And it just looks like a long kind of blade,
actually,
right?
Actually, in Korean, we say kalchi, and kal, that is from the sword, knife.
Even though, isn't it spelled kalchi, as in with a kiok? But it kind of sounds like kal
but
at the same time.
But we usually pronounce it kalchi.
Oh. Oh,
or maybe it's a
know.
Dialect. I always say kalchi.
That's interesting,
yeah,
isn't it?
It does look like a knife.
Yeah, a little bit like an old-fashioned sword. And I've never seen that kind of, what was it? What would you call it? Maybe a pot, but a very long pot that just
long
fits
square.
That fish in there.
Yeah.
That's
the
amazing.
The whole one piece. And usually they have this, the kalchi, the cutlass fish, that they got it nearby the Jeju-do Island.
Ah.
And be careful with the needle inside. It has the needle usually in its head or maybe some other parts.
Oh, from fishing?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
That's terrible. I'm very scared to eat it now.
Yeah, it's scary, but it also gives a kind of a impression that it's really fresh. They just got it.
And it's not been fish farmed or anything like that. That's interesting.
It's got wild sea.
It's got many bones in it. And it's served in that kind of stew-like, spicy stew-like state you saw in the video.
That was so good. Very spicy, but in a delicious way.
We've got lots of messages coming in. Benny from the Philippines saying, oh my, the bread looks so delicious. I've had the halabong chocolate many times. That's the famous like gift to give. It's like orange chocolate, I suppose, in the West. But the halabong bread, I didn't know that was such a thing. Yeah, that's interesting, isn't it?
I think it became a trend that it's a good trend, actually, that we're seeing more and more restaurants and cafes trying to develop with some new menus, blending in with some local foods and fruits, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah. And trying to put halabong in things, because halabong, we say orange, but it's not exactly an orange. It's kind of like a mutant between an orange and a tangerine, because I guess the way you eat it is you peel off the skin like a tangerine, but it's big like an orange, right? The pieces. And it's so delicious. I do love it. Yeah.
It's much more soft than the orange. It's easily peeled. with your hands.
Yeah, it's not like an orange where that's really tough to do. And so the bread, if you were just listening, not watching, it had that kind of halabong powder or crunchy stuff sprinkled on top. Mm-hmm. And it was a good combination, according to Jen.
Yeah, it was. And some message from Jenga. Oh gosh, I don't eat seafood, but the second fish looks so good. Halabong bread looks so good. I'm blaming Jennifer if I get drool on my workstation.
I hope it's a waterproof keyboard.
That's a huge compliment for me. I'm flattered.
That will be okay. Steve, who's obviously visited Jeju and had good memories, says, did you manage to visit Hallim Park or Chungcheon Falls or the lava tubes?
Right. There's just so many spots that I missed.
Yeah, you can't get to them all, right? But you were saying that kind of hill formation is one of those Oreums, those lava tubes, is it? Is that what the hills sometimes are?
Yeah, Oreum, it looks like a hill, but much higher than the hills that you might imagine. Uh-huh. It's also the production of volcanic eruptions. You should know that this whole island is a result of the volcanic eruption. And Hallasan is the center. It's centered in the very middle of the Jeju Island, but you can see Oreum here and there, like Saebyeol Oreum.
There are famous ones here and there.
Those are one of those very popular ones.
Yeah, so you can basically tell that Hallasan is the big volcanic formation in the middle, and that's how islands form volcanically, right? They spew out the lava and it hardens to rock. And you can see volcanic rock everywhere on the coast, right? Yeah. Especially, and with the little walls they build, like around their houses and stuff, is usually volcanic.
And
rock.
Also, since you've just mentioned the walls, it's usually made with hyeomwam, the basalt, the red, black rock with some holes inside.
You can buy souvenirs, right?
Yeah.
The little, what's it called? It's not a
harubang.
Harubang. I was going to say halabong as well, but it's not a halabong. Harubang is the little, like, kind of grandpa figure, right? I love that. Yeah. That's so cute. Why don't we get to some photos and then messages if we have time? We want to get to these for sure. Donna in New York says, these are some pics from Jeju in 2018. These are from Seogwipo, all of them. The Dragon Rock and the Chicken Meal, though, from Jeju City. This is one of the famous waterfalls. I think that might be Chungcheon.
It is Chungcheon, right.
Which, like, falls right next to the sea, which is quite impressive, right? And that's the bridge down near what looks like a little port or a harbour around there with a sail kind of motif to the bridge tower there. And then you've got the henyo. Oh, wow.
Oh, that's cute.
And it's got a little henyo sign on the toilet for women. Aw, isn't that nice? And then there's the, what's it called again?
Oh, thank you. That is the dol harubang.
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 And you don't have to buy a big one like that. They sell little pocket souvenirs, right?
Dol means stone. Harubang is from harabochi, grandpa.
Oh, isn't that cute? And then I think you've also got some photos of the dragon rock and chicken meal. Are they there? Yes. Just before this photo was the dragon rock.
Yongduam.
That's the one that I saw. That's different to the beach that you were showing us earlier,
yes, very
it?
Different. This is just one rock, which is very impressive. Mm-hmm. But the one that I showed is much bigger in size.
It's like a cliff almost, right?
Whole cliff.
I didn't know they had two separate ones. I thought you were showing us this because this is near Jeju City in the airport, and you can check it out. And then you just showed as well some chicken and chips, which is not traditional Korean food, Donna, but in Jeju, they got lots of trendy, like, fusion and Western foods these days, right? You've got something to show from Siska in Indonesia. You've got a couple of pages here, Jen.
Yeah, Siska says, what I remember for today, hashtag, is this market. It's called...
That's for the hashtag earlier, Sebyeok, but I think we've got these photos from
below.
Here.
Okay, sorry. Seongsan Iljulbong on the background and the view from the top. Oh, so that's the picture we're seeing.
That's when you come into, like, the car park area and then you go up the top. Wow, look at that photo.
Wow, you went up to the
did
top.
You go, have you been
I
to the top?
I did a couple of years back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With a child, it's probably not the best idea. It's not too bad a walk, but little kids and elderly people might find it difficult. But you don't have to be a professional hiker or anything, right? And that is the photo to take.
Aww. Yeah. That's so nice.
It looks like something from one of those animes where they have the floating island in the sky. Mm. I think there's a Japanese one by that name. It just reminds
floating
me of
island,
that.
Yeah. That's the misty weather there, right?
And then Siska's hiding in among the bloom here, the yellow flowers.
I think that is the 유채꽃.
Rapeseed flower, I think.
Seasonal flower. And I hope to see it this time, which I was a bit late in May.
Because, yeah, it's in bloom now, I know, in Incheon Airport, when I drove past the other day. Because Jeju blooms earlier because it's further south, isn't it? And then some photos in front of some temples as well.
Yeah, and Siska also went to Sambangsan and the Buddhist temple there. So the mountain behind, we're seeing the Sambangsan again.
That's from your video as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
Looks amazing.
That is the Sambangsan.
And then if we can quickly just get to Ing Yin's photos. I don't want to miss you out, Ing Yin. And this is for indoor activities, as Josh was asking, not Josh, Aaron was asking us. You're confused when you hear about the different temples, but when you went there, you went and saw the touristy sites like the Teddy Bear Museum, Chocolate Museum, Tangerine Plantation, and you wish you could have seen more of its natural beauty. That looks like a chocolate Batman for some reason.
Oh, wow.
And then I think we got some Teddy Bear Museum pictures. I thought Teddy Bear Museum would be really childish and rubbish. It's actually good fun. Like, you get into
there.
It.
And they would do little recommend?
They do little scenes of history with teddy bears. Oh. So like an Abraham Lincoln teddy bear and things like this. And the kids love it as well. Jen, thank you so much. With Jeju, we could go on for weeks and weeks, I feel, right? But we're going to see Udo Island perhaps next time.
Yeah, I'll be back with Udo content next week.
Looking forward to it. Have a good week and we'll see you then.
Bye.